U.S. relationship is an integral part of both of our successes. We have shared technology, shared knowledge, and shared innovation. Of course, one of the key players in our self-driving vehicle surge is our host today, the BlackBerry QNX. The company has quickly become a world leader in security-embedded software. Its newest operating system is being used in more than 60 million vehicles, from luxury cars to minivans, and we saw that in the presentation just a few moments ago. From speaking with John and many other industry leaders, I know that BlackBerry QNX values the business environment that we have created in Canada. Companies are drawn to our talent pool, our ideas, and our immense capacity to innovate. In Canada, ladies and gentlemen, we are betting on innovation. And we're making sure every person has the skills to work in the economy of today and tomorrow. So if you look at the success of the product that's going to be launched today, if you look at the turnaround success of BlackBerry, it is fundamentally rooted in the people in the company. And we recognize that as a federal government. And our government is playing an active partnership role with the automotive sector. We're investing in people, technology, and in businesses. In fact, just to highlight that point, and I think John would like this for the long-term success of the company, we are teaching close to 1 million kids to learn how to code. This is about digital literacy. This is about understanding how to solve problems. So if you know anyone looking to expand their business into Canada, let them know that in a matter of years, we will have an army of talented Canadians with the STEM and digital skills needed for future technologies, particularly in the automotive sector. So I gotta be brief, that was the promise I had made to John. So I'm gonna wrap up and introduce the man of the hour. Under his leadership, BlackBerry has been reestablished not only as a Canadian icon, but a global one. The first time BlackBerry changed the world was with its smartphone, and I must confess, I still have a BlackBerry smartphone. Today, it is shaping the Internet of Things with its market-leading software and innovations. When this individual took the helm of BlackBerry, the company was losing $1 billion a quarter. Imagine the losses it was amassing. But today, the company is delivering record-breaking growth in its software business. To tell you more about the company's latest product, let me introduce its CEO, John.